Matter is the stuff of life. I'm made up of matter, you're made up of matter, the food we eat is made up of matter. To begin to understand how our body breaks down food into nutrients, we need to understand a little bit about what matter is. All matter is made of elements. Elements are the basic building blocks of matter. The periodic table, like you see here, is a convenient way to organize the elements, and if you take a basic chemistry class, you'll learn more about how the periodic table is arranged. Note how each of the elements is indicated by an abbreviation. You'll see a lot of these abbreviations as we move through nutrition. Here's carbon, C. That's an easy abbreviation, C for carbon. But sometimes the abbreviations are based on the Latin term for an element, and you just have to know what each abbreviation is. Like sodium. The Latin term for sodium is natrium, so the abbreviation for sodium is Na. The Latin term for potassium is kalium, so the abbreviation for potassium is actually a K. The Latin term for iron is ferrum, so iron gets an Fe abbreviation. Now, we are matter, so we are made up of elements too. We're mostly carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. If you take the symbols for these four elements, you get CHON. And that's how I like to remember what the most abundant elements in the body are. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. If you look at these other elements present in smaller amounts, some of them probably sound familiar. Sodium, potassium, magnesium, these are all minerals that we need in our diet. Even more elements are present in very small amounts, but they're still absolutely critical, like iodine or iron. When elements interact, they form compounds. The properties of a compound can be very different from the properties of its component elements, and salt is a great example of this. The chemical name for table salt is sodium chloride. Elemental sodium is a soft metal. Elemental chlorine is actually a gas, but when they combine together, we get this white crystalline powder that our taste buds just love. When elements combine, they always combine in a fixed ratio. Take sodium chloride. Sodium and chlorine always combine in a 1-to-1 ratio. One sodium particle for every chlorine particle. The chemical symbol for sodium chloride incorporates this ratio. You take the symbol for sodium, remember that's Na, and the symbol for chlorine, that's Cl. They combine in a 1-to-1 ratio and you get NaCl, the chemical symbol for salt, sodium chloride. Water is also a compound. The chemical formula for water is H2O. H is for hydrogen, O is for oxygen. That 2 in there means that there's 2 hydrogens for every 1 oxygen. So water is a compound with a 2-to-1 ratio. In order to understand how elements interact, we need to understand what elements are made of. Elements are basically accumulations of atoms. And an atom is the smallest unit of an element that still has the chemical properties of that element. So a single atom, the smallest unit of an element that can still basically be called that element. Atoms are made up of smaller particles, the electrons, protons, and neutrons. Electrons and protons both have charges. Electrons have a -1 charge, protons have a +1 charge. Neutrons are neutral. That's why they're called neutrons. Protons and neutrons cluster together in the center of an atom. This is called the atomic nucleus. Electrons circle around the nucleus, a bit like the Earth orbiting the Sun. Now, this is a convenient way to picture the atom, but it is a bit unrealistic. There is a central nucleus with protons and neutrons, but that nucleus is surrounded by what's more like an electron cloud. not quite the perfect regular little electron planets pictured here. I'm going to end this video here so that you can go on to the next and learn about how atoms interact with each other.